Hello Capricorn, Happy New Year and welcome to 2021 reading, the ultimate reading. At first, we're gonna take a look at the overall energy and then we will look at career separate, health separate, love separate, blessings, and I will talk about the giveaway that I have for you. So let's start with the overall energy. This is the overall card for 2021, and it's Keeper of the Well reversed. It's a challenging card, okay? It's not, rainbows and blah blah, but it's something that reminds you to take really a step back, to really stop where you are, stop in your tracks, because you realize that you are going the wrong way. And already I'm the same time when I'm talking about it, I'm seeing this in the cards as well. It's you, the things were not going your way at all. And you were starting to lose your energy, starting to lose your power. And so in 2021, you step back and you stop doing whatever you're doing in order to find, to gain back your energy, first of all, to get back well, to rest a little bit, to recoup and recruit so that you can be stronger for later endeavors. But right now, Capricorn, you are not ready, okay? You're not ready to start anything new, any new projects, anything like restore. If there's been anything wrong in relationship, you need to fix the relationships. If your health wasn't good, fix your health first, then move on to other things, okay? Whatever hasn't been okay, it's time to take a look at it and it's time to deal with it. Yeah, no more postponing, okay? You have to deal with it this year. You will be forced to. So, with the Swords, yeah, this is mental clarity. This is you finally understanding what's going on. What was the issue that was keeping you from having abundance, from having security, from feeling safe, from feeling, rock steady? Something was shaking your ground. And there's been conflicts. Maybe your inner conflict, maybe conflict with the environment. Because whenever there's an inner conflict, of course there's gonna be conflict on the outside as well. It's gonna demonstrate itself in reality. You fighting with the people around you, your co-workers, your, just not seeing head to head with people around you. It's because you have this inner conflict that you need to resolve first. Like maybe you don't want to be doing your job that you've been doing for so long. You don't want to be doing this anymore. Because I remember I had this in Capricorn reading. Like you want to go higher, but it's something totally other than expected from the environment, from the people. Yeah, so if you're trying to please other people, if you're trying to make them accept your new calling, your new feeling that you have about life, and it's a lost cause, okay? And also if you're trying to be acceptable and doing things so that you are acceptable, yeah, and you're keeping yourself down, it's a lost cause. So you might as well accept that they're not gonna accept and that they are gonna have blibli and blah blah on the side. But it's better that you are you and that you do your thing. And don't look on them. Okay? Who cares what they think? That's what drains you actually. But I see this situation, it will improve. It certainly will improve. You're gonna have to move on. You will move on. If it means moving house, If it means moving cities, moving from the current job, moving from whatever, you move on. You get away from the situation. Okay? Also, this is the card of moving on, because like this, he's crying for what he lost. He doesn't look at what he's left. But what is left is the true things that are always by him, that he cannot lose. But here, you no longer cry for what you lost. You realize what you have left. You realize that you have to move on with this, what you have. And you have to create from what you can, from what you have, not from what you don't have. Okay? If you don't have $1 million investment to start a business, you start with $1. Okay? Yeah, there's been collaborations going wrong. There's been fighting with people in your workplace as well. It was just not right, or you didn't have enough experience to just show the full you to work the desired path. So you were making a choice between desire and what you have been doing so far. Wow, so these are big decisions. I guess you finally make the real big decision. But don't feel discouraged. Why would you feel like it's impossible what you want? The magician reversed. He's not manifesting what he wants. Are you getting your manifestation out of control? Because of doubt, because of self-loathing, because of feeling like it's not right, like it's not good, it's not accepted, maybe even evil. Because I also know a lot of dark magicians, and they're fighting with the preconceived notion that what they're doing is evil. Even though they're not doing anything evil, they're not killing people, they're not doing any crazy rituals, they're just working with the demons, And it's hard to work with the spirit if you constantly fear the spirit, if you constantly think it's evil. This is just an example. It's also, for example, like the old way of thinking, you have gotta have a job and blah blah blah. And now if you don't want it and you wanna do something else for a living or just enjoy your life, it feels like you're wrong, and people would make you feel like you're wrong. So it's hard to deal with that on top of doing the actual work that you want to do and doing the actual changes. They're alone. On itself, they are hard, but if you have to deal with other people as well and yourself, doubting yourself, it's not any easier. And I know this, I can understand you. Okay, so that's overall energy. We will now take a look at career, what's going on there. Okay, see you there. Career. Prosperity, money, okay, everything in one package for 2021 for Capricorn. Judgment. You see, in overall energy, we had judgment in reverse. But in career, the judgment is upright. The judgment is finally answer your calling, finally doing what you were meant to do, finally doing what you're called to do, what you want to do, what you've been wanting for so long. Yes, in 2021, you get your guts and you start doing it. Wow. Yes, with King of Wands, you're a bit inexperienced, you're a bit shaky. Maybe not as determined, but look at this. You get your success. You do get your success, okay? This is your true calling, and you will be rewarded for your good works. Even though you're inexperienced, it means nothing because you only get better. You're already good, but you will only get better. This is King of Wands. He is still king, even if it's reversed. He's still king, okay? So he's still good at this. He just needs a little, you know, you just need a little more fluid, a little more butter in your joints, but you get it as you go. Hierophant reverse, yes, you are totally going against the tradition, against something that everyone else wanted you to do. You're totally going just your own way, and you don't care of authority, you don't care of anyone. Yes, you still do tame yourself. Yeah, you still are not unleashing the full beast inside you. You are still going step by step, okay, mile by mile, but you are getting there. You're getting there, and you have your goals set. Yeah, you are still walking in your darkness. You still haven't had the full explosion of success, but you're getting there. And you set your goals and you move towards them. You're being guided by your own inner intuition, by your own inner guidance. But this four is a success. It's a marriage, it's a commitment. You commit to also the Hierophant, you commit to your path. And it's a small success as well. No, it's not a small success. It says like you will get the big, how you say this word? You will get big success, big acknowledgement, you will be respected. Yeah, big rewards. You know, when he pronounces him a knight or a prince or whatever. So you get your title, finally. It means you can, maybe you finish college or pass an exam or some sort. And this brings you a lot of money. It says you win a lot of money, okay? This is not small amounts. You win a lot. And when you're rich, come back to me, please. Expecting. So you also expect a lot. But wait. Because you have to wait. You have to be patient, okay? Wait, what was this on the bottom deck? His thoughts. Wow. Look how he's carrying himself highly. So you are this gentleman now. You are this important person now, okay? And you expect nothing but the best. But you do have to be patient with this. Yes, in 2021, this is promised to you. But still, it doesn't mean it's gonna come in January. I feel like maybe in March or it's gonna need maybe 3 months after you get your title. I don't know. But it's not gonna be exactly the same moment. You are gonna have to experience some strength. You're gonna have to show your strength, your patience, okay? Your resilience, okay? Pay attention. So yeah, observe your inner guidance, your inner signs that are repeating themselves. And they are bringing you precious messages. So I did tell you that you do follow your inner knowing, your inner intuition. Yeah. Whenever in doubt between whether to go this way or that way, always listen to yourself. Listen to your intuition, because deep down inside you do know what you're doing actually. Allow yourself to receive. When I said you were getting a lot of money, did you get any cringes? Did you think she is full of it? She is bullshitting us? That's because of this, because you need to allow things to happen, okay? It's all about allowing it, letting it go. Open your hands Whatever you are holding on to, just open and free it. And then things can start running towards you. Okay? Have you been trying to micromanage every small thing? I don't know. But you see, it says trust. You don't know. Yeah. But I know. It says trust. You have to trust. Allow it. Your wishes are coming true. What you asked for is being is coming into life, okay? Stay positive and follow your guidance. You are being divinely guided. You need to follow it and don't try to stay positive like all the time. Like, I know this is not possible, but don't, even if there's bad days, everyone has bad days, everyone has challenges, everyone wants to send everybody to some ugly place sometimes, but overall positive energy, keep your faith. It means keep your faith. Do not lose your faith. Okay, don't lose those childhood dreams that you had. Because in those dreams, you were so sure that it is possible, that you, not only possible, that you will achieve it. And why are you now? What is this stage fright that you're having? I don't know. Do not ever, ever give up on your dream. Always keep them, because your dream is your destiny. Your dream is your rightful self, okay? Yeah, be ready to work in teams. Be ready to work with people. And again, look at this, look at this. Oh my God. Listen to your true emotions. So, and don't let others persuade you to do something you know it's not right. I told you, it's in you, your guidance. Your intuition is guiding you the right way. Do not listen to other people. But at the same time, it says relax. Everything is in its finest order. Everything is happening according to plan. You're doing the right thing, okay? And everything is going well. There is no blockage. There is nothing. Don't you be your own blockage. But right now, I don't see any blockage. You are getting your success, your money, your everything is coming your way. Now, I've completed the career. And after this, wait, what is after this? Yes, health. See you at health. Okay, Capricorn, let's take a look at your health. It's actually the next morning. I had to take a sleep because I was tired. And yeah, first is health and then is the rest, right? So the first card that came out was love yourself. And on the badge, when I see this, okay, this is going to be about mental health, about getting peace inside your mind, you know, your inner calmness. And so 21 is gonna be all about finding that inner peace, all about accepting yourself, because non-acceptance of yourself, of who you are, what you are, how you look like, and not accepting the issues that you have, it creates even physical pain, physical manifestations of diseases. So this is the root. The root is to find your own inner stability, okay? You have to trust your guidance. So look at this. Love yourself, trust yourself, okay? And then there is the trust card. You have to trust that you are able to heal yourself, that you are able to do what you want to do. Let me show you all the cards. I still don't have a tripod so that I can put it right above and you could see the cards, but I'm gonna get it probably soon. So you do have healing abilities, and Even if you take medicine and you go to doctors or you take alternative therapy, it's gonna be you that heals yourself, okay? You have to set the attention, focus your energy, because there's an incredible force in strong intention, okay? Intention. Like, I wanna achieve this. And I'm gonna do everything in my power and everything that I know that I can do to achieve this. And no matter what obstacles come your way, you take them and you go with the flow and you deal with the challenges, right? It's almost as if you say, oh, I'm gonna pass this exam, but I don't know this and I don't know that. And you go and you study. And even if you get obstacles and challenges, you know that you're gonna do it, and you don't hesitate or you don't cry when it comes. You just do it, okay? Also, there is some family issues. Maybe this is what is eating you from inside. Something about, look, the goddess card. When I got this card, I felt strongly mother. I could hear only the word mother. So if it's your mother, or if it's you as a mother, you have children here. Wait, I will take the three cards that resonate the most. The mother, the children, and forgiveness. If it's your mother, this is something that happened to you as a child. Maybe mother was distant. Maybe she was struggling on her own with her own emotions, and you were left alone, you know, to deal with yourself. She didn't care you, like, she wasn't too much, not absent. How you, what's the opposite of absent? Present. She wasn't so present as a mother. So you were left to deal with yourself on your own. And as a child, you didn't know how to deal with yourself. And you do hold the resentment towards her for whatever happened. But you have to let go, let it go. Okay? You have to forgive in order to feel well inside, because it's eating you. Okay? The other thing is you as a mother. Maybe you don't forgive yourself because you weren't as good of a mother as you could be, or as you would be now. Okay? But you also have to forgive yourself for that, because again, it's eating you. You've done your best. Your mother has done her best at the time that she knew that she was able and capable. And there's no point in holding on to this past, because just you need to let it go. And how to let it go? You could, you know, set intention that you want to, and the right decisions will come your way. You will know which treatment to choose. You will know, you know. Then we have vegetarian, vegan, and crystals. So you might want to work with crystals. They could help you to get the things out and to transmute it, to transmute the energy. Okay, as you set your intention, what you want to do, you will find the right crystal for you, okay? It could, I will not say which crystal. I don't know the crystals too much. I know a little bit, so I will not speak. Try, but look at the colors. So this is your guidance. Blue, pink, and purple. Purple I know is amethyst, pink I know is rose quartz, blue, aquamarine. Okay. Try to look up those three. Rose quartz is, yes, it's for heart, it's for love, it's for the healing. And I don't know, I will tell you, look up the crystals. Maybe you'll find something to help you with your issue, okay? Look out in Google their properties, and then you will see which one's the right one for you. Or get a healer that works with crystals. They could help you. Vegetarian, vegan. So it's about food, it's about diet. And also vegetarian and vegans, we look at them as someone it like an alternative diet. So alternative healing might be the one for you. But when we go back to this card, vegetarian, vegan, so you need to take a look at the diet that you're having. I'm not saying you have to be vegetarian or you have to be vegan. It could be even the opposite, that you are vegetarian and vegan and it's just not the right type of diet for you. We are different. Bodies are different. Everyone reacts to different food differently. Okay? So take a look at what is not working for you. Do you, if you have stomach issues, inflammations, you might benefit from eating more fruits and vegetables and less dairy products, less meat, blah blah. Okay? Or if you're vegetarian, because I've tried vegan food. And I love vegan food, but the problem is like vegans, they use a lot of grains, which for me personally, they don't go well with my body. I get bloated, I just don't digest grains as well, okay? I'd rather eat meat and vegetables than so many grains because it makes me sick. It makes me have a headache and I don't feel good. I cannot perform after eating that kind of food. And yes, vegetables and fruits for me are fine, but grains, no way. And if you are a vegan, you have to eat a lot of grains as well because you need to get those calories in, yeah? Rices and I don't know, any kind of wheat. It's not, yeah, grains, wheat, yeah, that kind of food. So if you feel that it's not for you, why would you insist? Think about it, okay? To each their own. We are all very different here. So yeah, I don't know if I remind you already, because when I read, I don't know sometimes what I say. I am not a doctor, and professional health advice you get from professionals. Here we just take a look at energies, okay? Don't get me wrong. So that's it for health. Now we are moving on to love. Love, Capricorn 2021. The first card we have serendipity reversed. So this year, you're gonna have to deal with some challenges, okay? It's gonna be you meeting a person, and this is most probably someone from your past, okay? Someone from your ex or someone you knew before, it's the reconciliation card. And maybe it's your ex that you haven't talked in a while, seen in a while, and then with some serendipitous events, like synchronicities, you meet each other and like, wow, how is this possible? So, and then you think, oh, so it's gotta be meant to be if it happened like that. Yeah, it wasn't in our control. Yes, it's meant to be, but it's meant to be because you need to learn another lesson. Yeah, so pay attention to the red flags. The signs are warning you. This person is not the right, I wouldn't say they're the right person for you, because why do we have then the thief card here? And the page of wands, although this is a good card, but with this together, oof, this is a F-boy. F-boy, and they have some alternative intentions behind it, or just to use you for sex, or they use sex to draw you in, but they want something else, yeah. I wouldn't trust them. And there's gonna be warnings, there's gonna be red flags, and there's gonna be a tower moment that if you ignore those red flags, you're gonna Just take it as the universe is watching over you, okay? And if you're going in the wrong direction, it's okay. It's okay because you're gonna be helped from above anyways. Okay? It's gonna be the lesson to learn how to pay attention to the red flags. To learn how to discern, how to respect yourself and love yourself so that you don't go into situationships or weird, you know, weird things. So don't think, oh, just because there is synchronicities, there is the serendipities events, that now we are meant to be, this is the one for me. It's the one for the moment that you need and for the lesson that you need. Yeah, they are the one for that. But they're not the one to stay with you and to be your life partner. Okay? You are gonna have to work a little bit more. Okay? You're gonna have to show, like, real resilience, real discipline, to work on yourself. Like, even in the health reading, we said, like, you have to forgive something, you have to let go of something. There is still something that is bothering you, and you're really gonna have to work on that. And then, when you work on that, and when you get strong there, when you know how to go the right way, which one is the right path for you, then it opens up for you, actually. It opens up for you, and then you get big happy changes, okay? And then you are ready. You are ready for the one after this commotion, okay? So be positive, stay positive, even though I'm predicting something bad for you. But trust me, it's not as bad as you think. Just don't go too far with the person. Like, I think you're gonna be protected. You're not gonna go too far. Because when the tower strikes, it strikes. Okay? And you're gonna... I'm glad that I'm here to warn you about it so that you don't stay in that relationship and think, no, but it was meant to be, we have to figure it out. No, you don't have to figure it out with the wrong person. You have to figure it out, yes, for yourself, okay? For yourself, figure it out and know your right way. Know the kind of love that you deserve. It's all about self-respect and self-love and self-acceptance. And if they don't accept the full you, the way that you are, they have no business doing with you. If there's someone from your past, there's a reason why you've broken up before, yeah? What do you think that is going to be different this time? So yeah, after this, you're ready and let me know. I want to know when that moment comes for you, but it's going to be beautiful after that, okay? It's going to be like the final lesson before you get... Ta-da! You know what I mean? Okay, so now the next one, we will take a look at the blessings. Okay, here I have my blessings box. Or basket. Let's see what blessings are coming to you in 2021. Okay, also three blessings. Whew. Friendship, visit, and happiness. Oh, wow. Okay, so there's gonna be a friend visiting you, and it's gonna be very happy. You're gonna be very happy for that. You're gonna have beautiful events happening, although I just told you something bad about love, but you know, you can use the time that you have with the person, or it's gonna be someone completely else. But yeah, you will see friendship, visit, and happiness for you in 2021. Also now, next is the giveaway. Okay, for the giveaway, I am giving away three readings, okay? Three free personal readings where you can ask me a question. There's gonna be one 10-minute reading where you ask me one question. Then there's gonna be two Not one, two 20-minute readings where you can ask me or one question or two questions. It's up to two questions. Then it's one 30-minute reading, one where you can ask me up to three questions. You can ask me one questions and I go 30 minutes about that, or you ask me three different questions, okay? I'm giving it away for free. All you have to do is write in the comments below that you want to participate in the giveaway. That's it, nothing more. Thank you. And yeah, what is coming next for January? I've prepared some special. I told you also in December. I am a little bit late in on the schedule, but I'm gonna do what I wanna do. And I wanna do the North Nodes. Okay, so now I've told you a secret. I'm not sure if I'm gonna tell other people's secrets. So stay tuned, subscribe here. Stay tuned for what's to come because I have beautiful readings coming for you. Thank you, Capricorn. Happy New Year. Happy birthday as well, of course. Oh my God, Capricorn, I almost forgot it's your birthday. So happy birthday. Celebrate it well. Be good, be happy, and see you. Bye.